children, today I will explain to you chapter 5th of your English reader book. The chapter name is The Lake Kailok. It is free, written by W.B. Yeats. The Lake Isle of Innisfree, written by W.B. Yeats in 1888, is a 12-line poem composed of 3 quatrains. It reveals the poet's nostalgia for the peace and tranquility he enjoyed on the Lake Isle during his childhood. Okay, let's start the poem. I will arise and go now, and go to Innisfree, and a small cabin built there of clay and wattles made. 9 bean rows will I have there, a hive for the honeybee, and lie alone in the bee loud glad. I here refers to the poet William Yeats. He says that he wants to go to Innisfree. Over there, he will build a small house for himself with clay and small sticks. और इसका वो क्या use करेंगे? उसका वो अपने जो room है उसके wall को बनाने में और fence को बनाने में, cabin के fence को और wall को बनाने में use करेगा. As he will need some food to eat also, तो इसके लिए वो अपने room के चारों तरफ 9 room में beans को उगाएगा. Also he will get the honey from the honeybee hive. He says that the open space where he will build his room will be full of buzzing sound of the bees, and over there he will live all alone in peace and tranquility. Here arise means stand up, cabin means room, wattles means twisted sticks for making fences and walls. Glad means clearing open space. And I shall have some peace there, for peace comes dropping slow, dropping from the veils of the morning to where the cricket sings. There midnight's all a glimmer, and noon a purple glow, and evening full of the linnet's wings. In this stanza, the poet says that when in Innisfree, he will feel peaceful, and he said that ye jo feeling jo peace ka hai, wo achanak nahi aayega, wo gradually or slowly aayega. He describes how he would feel peaceful. In the morning time, when it is cloudy and the view is not very clear, then it will appear as if the morning has worn a veil and has hidden itself. Looking at this scene will make him feel peaceful. ये सीन को देखकर भी उसे शांति मिलेगी. Further he says that when the male cricket insect will sing a song, that song will bring him at peace. और आधी रात को जब आकाश में तारे चमकेंगे तो उस शाइन को भी देख के उनको शांति मिलेगी. और दोपहर को जब सूर्य की रोशनी जो है पर्पल ग्लो करेंगे, तब उसे भी देख के जो पोएट है इस पोएम के W.B. Yeats, उसे भी देख के उनको शांति मिलेगी. ड्यूरिंग द इवनिंग व्हेन ही विल सी द लिनेट बर्ड्स फ्लाइंग इन द स्काई, देन ऑल्सो ही विल फील पीसफुल. हियर वेल्स मीन्स अ पीस ऑफ फाइन मटेरियल वॉन बाय मैन टू प्रोटेक्ट और हाइड द फेस. क्रिकेट मीन्स already बोल चुके, झिंगूर means grasshoppers. I will arise and go now, for always night and day आई हियर लेक वाटर लैपिंग विथ लो साउंड्स बाई द शोर वाइल आई स्टैंड ऑन द रोडवे और ऑन द पेमेंट्स ग्रे आई हियर इट इन द डीप हार्ट स्कोर. In this stanza, the poet says that now he will stand up and go to Innisfree. क्यों? क्योंकि हमेशा जो लेक की आवाज है वो उनके माइंड में घूमता रहता है. This sound attracts him towards the lake. Whenever he is, चाहे वो रोड साइड में चल रहे हो या फिर ग्रे कलर के पेमेंट में चल रहे हो, he hears the sound deep in the innermost part of his heart. Night and day means all the time, lapping means striking, heart score means the innermost part of the heart. Okay student, I think now you all have understood this poem.